Hello all, 4Player Squad Gaming here, and this is our visual guide for beginners to Final Fantasy XIV and why you should be playing in 2021. You are probably here because you are getting bored or tired of your current MMO experience, and within this guide I'm hoping to show you some of the things that Final Fantasy XIV has to offer and offer some useful tips to get started. I have been playing for close to 2 years and have become well and truly addicted to the playstyle, community and overall experience this MMO has to offer. Starting a new MMO can be daunting, but with this guide I hope that I can make your experience easier and more enjoyable. With any MMO, and especially Final Fantasy XIV, there is almost too much content to complete and explore. However, Final Fantasy is unique with its vast main story questline that plays as a normal RPG. So let's get into the guide and start with character creation. This is the character creation screen, and we start with the race and gender. There are numerous different options here, and hopefully something to suit all players. Each race will have different attributes and stats, but they are so minimal that they should not deter you from picking one because you plan on playing a certain class. The appearance editor is vast, so have fun and design the perfect character for you. After this, you can pick your birthday on the Eorzean calendar and your patron's deity. Again, this has no effect on your character's stats or playstyle, and this is entirely just to add lore to your character. We then arrive at the class selection screen. Here you can see that we are split into two subgroups, Disciples of War and Disciples of Magic. Each will have a number of different classes or jobs, as they are called within Final Fantasy XIV, for you to play. Read the description and see what suits you. This should be your main role, but Final Fantasy XIV is unique in the fact that each character you create can play all the different jobs on the same character, so you can swap to another class later in the game if you choose. I'll go through the different classes in more detail later in the video. You will also notice that the starting area for the class highlighted will be shown in the bottom left corner. Each job will have its own unique starting city, and the main story questline will branch off from there. Don't worry, however, because before long you will have to venture to each main city and explore the rest of Eorzea, so don't be put off if you don't like the starting city you have. The homeworld selection screen is just a preference. However, some worlds can offer XP bonuses indicated by a gold star. They are sometimes available to be joined, and at other times they are locked to new players. The data center will be recommended to your geographical location. This is ideal as the players you will meet will most likely speak your language, which is a huge plus for such a social game. Pick your world and get ready to start your Final Fantasy XIV experience. The next part of this guide, I will quickly run through the classes available to you. We start off with a limited number of jobs and must pick one of these. Each class will develop into a new class at level 30 with added new abilities and playstyles. Some classes can only be started when your main class has reached either level 30, two more available at level 50, and two more at level 60. And as just announced, Sage at level 70. The five categories of class are Tank, Healer, Physical Range DPS, Magical DPS and Melee DPS. Just so you know, this is not a class guide and I will not be going in depth into these classes. I just want to give you a brief description of what to expect from each. The tanks available are Paladin, Warrior, Dark Knight and Gunbreaker. Marauder and Gladiator will become Warrior and Paladin respectively at level 30. Dark Knight is available at level 30, and Gunbreaker unlocks at level 60. The healer classes available are White Mage, Scholar, Astrologian, and soon to be released, Sage. Conjurer and Arcanist become White Mage and Scholar respectively at level 30. Astrologian is unlocked at level 30. The physical DPS classes are Monk, Dragoon, Ninja, and Samurai. Lancer and Pugilist and Rogue become Dragoon, Monk, and Ninja respectively at level 30. Samurai unlocks at level 50. The magical DPS classes are Black Mage, Summoner, Red Mage and Blue Mage. Thaumaturge and Arcanist become Black Mage and Summoner respectively at level 30. Red Mage is unlocked at 50. Blue Mage is unlocked at level 50 also. Blue Mage is a limited job type, leveling and playing differently to others. Make sure to research this role before playing. Finally, the physical range DPS classes are Bard, Machinist and Dancer. Archer will become Bard at level 30, Machinist can be unlocked at level 30, and Dancer at level 60. Here are some top tips for picking your class. Think about what playstyle you like and choose accordingly. Do you like to be in the middle of the fight as a tank? Do you want to play a supporting role as a healer? Or do you want to see huge DPS numbers? All of these can help you pick what class would be best. Remember that Final Fantasy XIV is unique in the fact that your character can eventually play all classes, and you can swap at any time, suit your mood or the content. Healers and tanks usually have shorter queue times within the duty finder. This can be helpful in progressing through the main story questline quicker, and lots of other content within the game. You can't really go wrong with any class you choose, and each has a unique experience that I'm sure you will enjoy. Each class will have its own story questline to enjoy, so it is definitely beneficial to play as many classes as you can. Let's take a look at the combat system. This is very intuitive within Final Fantasy XIV. Our action bars will fill up with abilities as we gain levels and unlock them. Assigning hotkeys to these can make your life easier, however this is up to you. As you can see, I have my Chocobo companion with me fighting by my side. Once unlocked, I highly recommend keeping this birdie around. This makes your life so much easier. Each class will have its own set of unique abilities. As this is a magical range class, you can see that most of my abilities have cast timers. Chaining abilities together can give you a higher damage output, and these are often called rotations. Rotations can also be described for tank abilities and healer abilities also. There are numerous guides about each class's ability rotations online. Keep an eye out for our class guides coming in the future. Once the fight has begun, the target will focus the player with the most enmity. Enmity is the threat level that the target gives to the attacking player. Tanks have abilities to raise their enmity so that targets will attack them instead of weaker party members. Killing monsters is one way that we can gain experience to level up. Completing logs such as the hunting log is another great way to gain XP in the early stages of the game. Targets that are required for your hunting log are shown by this symbol. A certain amount of each to be killed is required to complete the log. Fates are active time events that require a task to be completed within a set time limit. These can range from killing a highly powerful target to collecting and delivering goods. A fate is shown by this symbol, and they are a great way to gain XP and can offer some unique rewards, such as collectible items used for other in-game content. Fates are synced to your level if your current level is too high, which adds an extra degree of difficulty. So here is some quickfire information to help you along, and we start with our three starting locations. We have the nautical, coastal pirate haven that is Limsa Laminsa in Lanosha. Deep in the forest of the Black Shroud, we have the Nature's Bounty that is Gridania. And in the dusty, sandy plains of Thanalan, we have the City of Gold, Uldar. So where do I start, you may be asking? Here's a few tips to get you started. Your main goal is to complete the main story questline, and this should be your priority. The story is fantastic and truly showcases years of hard work from Square Enix. It will not only blow you away, it will also teach you how to play the game, have you exploring the whole of Eorzea and beyond, and give you a sense of accomplishment at the end of each quest. Keep an eye out for this symbol on your map or minimap to progress through the main story questline. Your current quest can be viewed on your duty list at the edge of the screen or in your journal. The main scenario quest you are currently on or the next quest to progress are shown in the top left corner in the current main scenario quest indicator. Other quests of interest to look out for are feature quests. These are shown by the symbol here and are very important to the game as they unlock new content. This can range from dungeons, trials, raids, events, and locations. Pick up as many as you can to see what Final Fantasy XIV has to offer. The backbone of any good MMORPG is having a great set of dungeons, and Final Fantasy XIV has just that. There are numerous dungeons to sink your teeth into, and each is unique and incredibly well thought out. Dungeons are done in a team of four and consist of one tank, one healer, and two damage dealers. Most dungeons are usually home to 3 to 4 different bosses, with the last usually being the toughest of the lot. This is a great way to challenge yourself and test out your fighting ability. Dungeons offer great rewards such as large amounts of XP to gear and weaponry for your character. We have 5 different ranks for gear, which are starting with white, which is common gear, pink, which is ethereal gear, green, which is scarce gear, blue, which is rare gear, and purple for relic weapons. My top dungeon tips for beginners are: tanks, remember to activate your enmity generation ability. Pick up as much loot as you can, and find your limit break hotkey and assign it to your hotbar. Trials are 4-player or 8-player events that involve killing one difficult boss, including some of our Final Fantasy fan favourites such as Ifrit, Shiva, and Ramu. Again, these are great for experience and offer some truly incredible rewards such as primal weaponry, which showcases the feel and essence of the primal you've just killed. Raids are varied from 8-player parties to 24-player parties, but don't be put off by thinking that these will last for hours. Final Fantasy does raiding perfectly, offering incredibly tough battles in timescales that keep the fight interesting and doable. With new content being released all the time, you will never run out of these events to do. My top tips for dungeons, raids, and trials are: pick a healer or tank role for shorter queue times, and the orange areas caused by enemies are called AoE, area of effect, and will only damage you when stood in the area when the area disappears. You can run into the animation after the AoE area has gone and not take any damage. Okay, so let's have a look at the duty finder. This is the go-to method for joining all of the content I've just mentioned. We can find it in our main menu down here after progressing to an early stage of the main story questline. Here we can see all the dungeons, trials and raids we have unlocked, along with other content such as the gold saucer. Our first tab shows us roulettes. These are daily boosts that we can do for much higher XP and high end rewards. Make sure to familiarise yourself with the duty finder early on. The world of Final Fantasy XIV is vast, and getting around can be an absolute joy. Early in the game we must walk and explore, which honestly is fantastic. With everything to see and do within the universe of Final Fantasy XIV, this is truly worthwhile. We also have an intelligent teleportation system called Aetherites. These blue crystals are used for teleporting around the world, but do have a cost to use. A small amount of gil must be spent to use them. However, using them inside cities to get to other areas within that same city is free. We need to attune to Aetherites before using them, so explore and unlock as many as possible. The teleportation action in your hotbars can be used to access all of the available Aetherites. Crafting in Final Fantasy XIV is like no other MMO. There are two subcategories, which are Disciples of the Land and Disciples of Hand. Disciples of the Land is for gathering materials, and the classes are Botany, Mining and Fishing. Disciples of the Hand are our production classes, and these are Alchemist, Armourer, Blacksmith, Carpenter, Culinarian, Goldsmith, Leatherworker and Weaver. Each is done as a separate unique job and even has its own story questline. I will not go any further into crafting in this video, but keep an eye out for our future crafting guides. So now we come to the end. I hope this visual guide has been helpful and given you a brief overview of the basics needed to start your Final Fantasy XIV journey. There is so much more content that I haven't mentioned in this video, and I can only recommend you get playing and experience it for yourself. If you have any questions or suggestions, please comment below and subscribe to see more Final Fantasy XIV content being uploaded every week. We are 4Player Squad Gaming, thanks for watching.